नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ओंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञानहर प्रत्यकर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूम वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंदयोगीन्द्रमथासु शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथासु पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यं वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जतस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गत्वप्यरी सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रयजनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् Okay, so towards the end of the Adhyasa Bhashya, we looked at Asya Anartha Hetov Prahanaya Atmaikatva Vidya Pratipate Sarve Vedanta Arabhyante to take away this Ajnana which creates adhyasa. So, asya adhyasasya anartha heto or kartrutva bhoktrutva. Sarvaloka pratyaksha is kartrutva bhoktrutva pravartaka adhyasa. That adhyasa is mithyapratya rupa and naisargika anadi ananta because ananta because it will not go away without jnana, which is pursued by kaschidhiraha. Therefore, asya anartha heto prahanaya. For nasha of prakarsha nasha. Hana, nasha is not, hanana is not just hanana, such as something that after nasha also comes up. So, ghata nasha takes place, but then ghata can be created again. Not that kind of a nasha. This is nasha in such a manner that it won't come up again. Therefore, pra upasarga has been added, prahanaya. So, the cause for anartha is this adhyasa along with its root cause, which is ajnana, that is taken away. Thereby, avidya takes away ajnana and ajnana karya, thereby kartrutva bhoktrutva raga dveshadi prayukta samsara, samsaranam. Atmaikatva vidya pratipatye sarve vedanta arabhyante. This is a commitment of all vedanta, all Upanishads. And the Vyakhya, it was said, in the Vyakhya it was said, Asya kartrutvadi anartha hetoho adhyasasya samulasya atyandikanashaha mokshaha sa kena ityaha atmaikatva pratipatti is the karana for prahanana, prakarshanasha, prahana of अध्यासा कर्तृत्वादि अनर्थ हेतु अध्यासस्य समूलस्य आत्यंतिक नाश मोक्षः सकेन इत्याह आत्मैकत्व प्रतिपत्तये ब्रह्मात्मैक साक्षात्कारस्य प्रतिपत्ति श्रवणादिभिः अप्रतिबंधेन लाभः तस्याः इत्यर्थः. सो ब्रह्म आत्म ऐक्य आत्मैक इज वन वे टू सी इट डायरेक्टली इज आत्मैक मीन्स आत्मा अलोन इज देयर नथिंग एल्स इज देयर. When nothing else is there, there cannot be another Atma, there cannot be Anatma also. When you say Atma alone is there, then that should be the understanding. Or the other meaning is Aikya between Atma and Brahma, which is not there in the Pada. Because of our study, we should add that, looking at the Upanishad Tatparya. Or Atma itself has the meaning of Brahma, once understood. Therefore, Brahma word need not be brought in again because once the भागत्याग लक्षण वर्क्स ऑन आत्मा मीनिंग त्वं पद एंड ईश्वर और ब्रह्म ऑन दी सगुण ब्रह्म ऑन दी तत्पद देन व्हाट रिमेन्स देर कैन नॉट बी एन ऐक्य बिटवीन देम दे आर वन अलोन सो एकस्य भाव ऐक्यम देर देर फोर एकस्य एकस्य पूर्णस्य आत्मनः भावः ऐक्यम् सो एकस्य भावः देर एकस्य कस्य एकस्य आत्मनः पूर्णात्मनः दैट सच्चिदानंद पूर्ण आत्मा नॉट सेगमेंटेड जीवात्मा बट पूर्णात्मा Who is called as a sakshi but is not even a sakshi without the sakshya mithyatva nischaya therefore that is atmaikatvam so shravanadi bhi apratimandena labha shravana manana nididhyasana is the sadhana for this pratipatti of sakshatkara of atma atmaikya meaning either atma or brahmatma ऐक्य सो दैट साक्षात्कार इज साक्षात्कार से प्रतिपत्ति विच इज अटेंड थ्रू व्हाट श्रवणादि भी एंड इट शुड बी अप्रतिबद्ध दैट साक्षात्कार इज इन सच अ मैनर दैट देर इज नो ऑब्स्टैकल देर इज नो विपरीत भावना ऑल्सो देर इज नो वेस्टीज ऑफ अज्ञान देर इज नो effect of ajnana left anymore that is the end resultant thereby sarve vedanta arabhyante so labha tasya ityartha then so pratipattaye tasya pratipattaye that is the meaning of this pratipatti is explained as in shashti as pratipatti प्रतिपत्ते चतुर्थी देर तस्याः कस्य ब्रह्मात्मैक साक्षात्कारस्य प्रतिपत्तिः श्रवणादिभि अप्रतिबन्धेन लाभः तस्याः इत्यर्थः सो तस्याः इन दि मूल दैट इज प्रहण आत्मिक विद्या प्रतिपत्ति सर्वे वेदांत आरभ्यन्ते अस्य अनर्थ हेतोः प्रहण आत्मिकत्व विद्या प्रतिपत्तिसु इट इज दि तस्याः Not sure why tasyaha. Brahma atmaikatva pratipatti. Brahmatmaika sakshatkarasya pratipattaye. Maybe there is a separate pathabheda there because tasyaha does not make tasyai. It should be tasyai. Tasyai by sandhi also. Possible tasya yeah. So some sandhi has taken place otherwise. So tasya ityartha or tasi for the pratipatti of brahmatmaikya sakshatkara. Vidyayam karanamaha and what is the cause for vidya? All Upanishads, any Upanishad, sarve also has the meaning of any, each and every also. So each and every Upanishad is leading to that. Even one Upanishad is sufficient. So Shaka Upanishad is sufficient. Each Upanishad covers the entire jnana. Avagati paryantam jnanam is covered in each and every Upanishad. One has to just be able to see it and it cannot be seen only in the mula. In a mantra alone, it may not be visible. Therefore, other supporting works are needed. So, Bhashya Tikadi Sampradaya, Guru Shishya Sampradaya, Karana Sampradaya is going on since ever. The first teacher being Dakshinamurti. Therefore, they fill in the gaps which are needed to see the Tatparya across Upanishads. Other Upanishads are quoted to fill in the understanding. There are no gaps per se, but to fill in the understanding as to how so, where else is it said? How can this kind of a meaning come from this mantra? For that, with the Shadlinga analysis, other Pramana is also quoted to make one understand. So, Sarve Vedanta Arabhyante. Arabhyante means what? Aditya Vicharyante Ityartha. वॉट इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द शास्त्र ब्रह्मसूत्र भाष्य इत्यादि अधीत्य हैविंग स्टडीड अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड देन विचार्यन्ते वॉट इज द तात्पर्य षडलिंग एनालिसिस इज डन इट इज नॉट जस्ट यू नो वर्ड बाय वर्ड मीनिंग और डिक्शनरी मीनिंग इट इज टू सी द कंप्लीट पिक्चर अक्रॉस द वेद वेदांत Although we say Vedanta, it will also be shown that sequentially, Kramena, Vedas are also, Karma, Upasana are also Karana for Chitta Shuddhi Dvara Moksha. So, Adhitya Vicharyante Ityartha, Vicharita Vedantana Brahmatmaikyam Vishaya Moksha Phalamiti Uktam Bhavati. So, Vishaya Prayojana Vatvat, Shastram Arambhaniyam. This is the conclusion. Some more speakers, loudspeakers. So, Vicharita Vedantana. The Vedantas, Upanishad, whose Tatpari Nishya has been done. Vicharita Vedantanam Vakyanam. Upanishad Vakyanam. So, it's Karmadhara. Vicharita Vedanta. Not Vedanta which is just, you know, Shruta or Patita. Vicharita. Manana Siddha. सो मनन सिद्ध वेद वाक्यानां वेदांत वाक्यानां उपनिषदां उपनिषदां और उपनिषद वाक्यानां ब्रह्मात्मैक्यं विषयः दि सब्जेक्ट मैटर इज ऐक्य बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड आत्मा नॉट ओनली ऑफ दि महावाक्य बट आल्सो अवांतर वाक्य विच रिवील द सेम ब्रह्म विच इज वन विदाउट दि सेकंड एकमेव अद्वितीय ब्रह्म मोक्ष फलम देयर बाय ज्ञानेन अज्ञाननाश तत्कार्यनाशोपि एंड देयर बाय मोक्षः फलम् इति उक्तं भवति दिस इज व्हाट इज इंप्लाइड इन द एंटायर दिस इज द अंडरकरेंट ऑफ द एंटायर डिस्कशन सो फार अर्थात तद्विचार आत्मक अर्थात तद्विचार विचारात्मक दिस विचार इज द स्वरूप ऑफ व्हाट हैज गॉन बाय इन द शास्त्रास अक्रॉस द बोर्ड अर्थात देयरफॉर तद्विचारात्मक शास्त्रस्य अपि द शास्त्र विच डज विच इज शास्त्र द शास्त्र विच इज बीइंग इंट्रोड्यूस्ड राइट नाउ द ब्रह्मसूत्र एंड द भाष्य इत्यादि शास्त्रस्य अपि व्हाट इज द विषय वेदांत विचार इज द विषय देयरफॉर तद्विचारात्मक शास्त्रस्य अपि Which does vichara on the Upanishad Vakyas, that Shastra also will have what Vishaya Prayojana? Same Vishaya Prayojana as Vedanta. Teva Vishaya Prayojane, te Dvivachana, Vishaya Prayojane, teke Vishaya Prayojane, iti jneyam. So Shastra also has the same Vishaya, meaning what? Brahmatmaikya. And then Prayojana is what? Mokshaha. Atyantika Dukkhanivrutti and नित्य सुख प्राप्ति और या दैट्स द आत्यंतिक दुख निवृत्ति एंड इट इज आल्सो सेड एज अतिशयन सुख प्राप्ति और आत्यंतिक सुख प्राप्ति इति ज्ञेयम् दिस शुड बी अंडरस्टूड एज दिस शास्त्र विल आल्सो हैव द सेम गोल हैज द सेम गोल एज has the same vishaya and has same phala as Vedanta. Nanu Vedanteshu pranadyupasti nam bhanat atmaikyam eva teshamartha iti katham ityata aha yatha chaiti. So the Puro Pakshi asked, there are so many karmas discussed, which is all right. We can set them aside, but at least upasanas. Upasana have a phala which is not swargadi phala. Upasana has a different phala from karma. Thereby Vedanta and these are in Vedanta proper. They are not in the karma kanda. Chandogya Upanishad is full of upasanas. Brihadaranyaka has a lot of upasanas. Keno Upanishad also after jnana there is some upasana discussed there. So in Upanishads themselves there are upasanas. What about them? What is their phala? As to how can you say aikya is the phala? Because there in the upasana, pranadi upasana is, especially if you look at as an example, then prana is upasta. the upasta and upasaka bheda is there. How can there be aikya? The upasaka or the upasti and the upasya, pranadi, devatas, they are talked about where? In the Vedanta itself. So, Vedanteshu pranadyupastinam bhanad. Since it is clearly seen that upasanas talk about bheda, atmaikyameva teshamartha iti katham. Katham nyayate. How can you establish also? Katham siddhyate ityataha yathacheti. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakara makes a conclusive statement. Yes, that is exactly what we are doing now in this nyaya prasthana. As to yathachayamartha in the mula, yathachayamartha sarvesham vedantanam, including the upasana and the avantara upanishad vakyas, sarvesham vedantanam yathacha ayamartha, this very aikya being the vishaya and prayojana of entire Upanishad. We are not going to set aside, no, this is not right, that is not right. We are not going to twist and add words like some other darshanikas do. We are going to show yatha chayamartha sarvesham vedantaram tatha vayam asyam sharirakam mimamsayam pradarshayishyamaha. We will show an established aikya as the vishaya and prayojana as moksha also. But here the question is regarding aikya. Moksha can be the phala later, but then first vishaya itself is not established, because bheda is also talked about in upasanas. This is exactly what we are going to show. Vayamasyam shari kutra, in this very shastra called as shariraka mimamsa. Inquire into the shariraka. Shariraka will see in the vyutpatti, will see in the vyakhyana. So the atma, basically shariraka is the atma. Sharire bhava, and sharira, sharire bhava sharira, and that ka pratyay is swarthe. The ka pratyay which you see is swarthe. So sa eva sharirakaha, atma, pratyagatma, which is brahmatma really. How do you know that? After mimamsa. So sharirakam mimamsayam pradarshayishyamaha. This is the mimamsa grantha which inquires into atma. So brahma jijnyasa. Vedanta mimamsa shastrasya vyachikhyasitasya idam adhyam sutram. This is not part of adhyasa bhashya really. This is an introduction to the first sutra. Therefore, anyway, we look at it since it's mentioned. So Vedanta mimamsa shastrasya vyachikhyasitasya. Vyakhyatum ishta is vyachikhyasita. That on which vyakhyana is desirable, it should be made. What is the first sutra? Idam adhyam sutram, and then Bhagavan Badarayana will say athato brahma jijnyasa, which we have already seen. The meaning we have seen in detail in the opening itself. We'll also look at the other three sutras for some kind of completion, just the basic meaning overview to have with the adhyasa bhashya. It is not hanging with the first sutra. We'll look at the four sutras, which are this brief introduction into the entire Brahma Sutras. So if there are 555 sutras, the first four sutras cover all the four padas. So four padas, across four padas, these four sutras give the introduction respectively into each padas. Then each padas have different adhikaranas and different number of sutras. So we'll see when we see that. So Vedanta Mimamsa Shastrasya Vyachikhyasitasya Idam Adhyam Sutram Athato Brahma Jijnyasa. So that is the entire Bhashya, Adhyasa Bhashya. In the Vyakhyana, the two interpretations are being given as to Yathachaiti Shariram Eva Sharirakam. So Shariram Eva Sharirakam Kutsitatvat. Okay, so swartha pratyaya is added earlier, not later, not after bringing so actually sharira you won't get unless you add a taddita pratyaya so my mistake shariram eva sharirakam so swartha pratyaya ka is added but anyway this has not caused adi vruddhi there it has not become sharira there yet so some kind of pratyayas are added there sharira so shiryate see sharira is also compared with samsara is compared with vruksha why because it can be felled the tree can be felled similarly samsara can be felled can be brought down can be cut asunder similarly here sharira withers away it is something which you should not associate with it is a karana for samsara again and again continuing endlessly so kutsitatvat this ka pratyaya shows the kutsitattu so this is how the derivation is शरीरमेव शरीरकम् सो दैट इज स्वार्थ देर तन्निवासी शारीरकः सो शरीरे भव शारीरक और शरीरके भवे भवः शारीरकः वन हू इज इन दी शरीर विच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड अ शरीरक सो तन्निवासी इज आत्मा एज दो हैविंग निवास इन ईच एंड एवरी शरीर जीवः तस्य ब्रह्मत्व विचारः मीमांसा so the jivatma is brahmatma that is the mimamsa that is the conclusion of the inquiry so brahmatva vicharaha how can this jiva be brahma why this jiva has to be brahma there is no other way so sambhavana then pramana will be shown and then the conclusion after the pramana meaning the conclusion of mimamsa should land in the shishya thinking that we are convinced that there is absolutely no other way meaning there is absolutely no way that I am jiva limited to sharira a samsari karta bhokta so initially how can I be brahma then how can I be anything but brahma there is no way that I can be anything but brahma this is the journey so brahmatva vichara mimamsa tasyam ityartha tasyam pradarshayishyamah यथा च अयम अर्थः सर्वेषां वेदांतानां सो दिस उपास्थीनां चित्तैकाग्र्य द्वारा आत्मैक्य ज्ञानार्थत्वात् तद्वाक्यानामपि महातात्पर्यम् ऐक्ये इति वक्ष्यते सो व्हाट विल बी सेड टेल मी व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आर गोइंग टू से सो गिव मी अ ग्लिम्स सो देयर भगवान भाष्यकर आंसर्स दिस क्वेश्चन रेज्ड बाय द पूर्व पक्षी एज टू प्राणादि उपास्ति भेद इज देयर सो Due to that bhana being there, how can there be aikya, aikya siddhi? So upasthi naam chittaika. So upasthi is one who is the upasthi is upasaka. One who is doing upasana, he has upasya pranadi devata. So upasthi naam chittaikagrya dwara. Through the what does upasana give? Upasana gives composure of the mind, the focus of the mind, while karma kanda. All the karmas in the karma kanda give the chitta shuddhi. Still ekagra. Chitta shuddhi is there, but then it cannot be focused to make the intellect sharp, to make the mind completely focused. Upasana is needed. So upasthi naam chittaikagrya dvara atmaika jnanarthatva. Upasthi is here it is in bhave meaning. Upasthi is not an upasaka, upasthi is the upasana itself. It is a bhavek tin pratya. I'm sorry. In the mula also, I explained not mula, in the Purvapaksha question also, I said upasthi is not an upasaka. I had a Brahma. I recalled what Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says in Panchadashi. He says the Uttama Adhikari is a Krutopasti. So there is a Bahuri. So I landed in I forgot that Krita as the Purvapada for Upasti. So Upasti, I was thinking, how can Upasti tin pratyaya be in Kartari? So Akartari cha karake sanyaya. So tin pratyaya here, Striyang tin, but it is not in the sense of Karta, obviously. So my mistake there. It is in the sense of Bhava. So Upasana is Upasti. So Krutapasti is the ultimate adhikari, the uttamottama adhikari. So one who has done upasana. Done in the sense not once or twice, it is to culmination with the devata becoming pratyaksha. Or whatever is upasana phala committed there, that kind of a thing has been completed by someone. So krita upastihi yena saha krutapasti krutopastihi. That is the bahuri vigraha there. So vigraha vakya. So I made a mistake here. So this upasti is the upasana. So upasti naam upasana naam chittaikya dwara atmaika jnanarthatvat. Why are they there? They are there to make the upasaka's antakkarana chitta completely focused, single-pointed. Thereby, antakkarana can behave as buddhi. When needed, it can give space, can give bandwidth to buddhi role to be played. Thereby, aikya jnana takes place through the focused mind, which is the resultant of upasti. Thereby, upastis have kramena aikya as the artha, as the prayojana. Therefore, what tadvakyanamapi, meaning upasti vakyanamapi, the upasana vakyas also have what? Mahatatparyam. They have mahatatparya. The tatparya, immediate tatparya is in chitta ekagrata, chitta ekagrata or chitta ekagryam. Shenji pratyabhaya. Then mahatatparyam, what is it? The same tatparya. Just like karmakanda was explained earlier. Karmakanda also, kramena, chitta shuddhi dwara. So, similarly, upasti also has mahatatparyam in aikya. Aikyeva mahatatparyam iti vakshyate. This is what will be said and it will be explained. Evam adhyasoktya brahmatmaike virodhabhavena vishayaprayojanatvat shastram arambhaniyam iti darshitam. So, what has been established is that through the adhyasa, explanation of adhyasa, since adhyasa is not only possible, there is a pramana, there is pratyaksha pramana, which is the main pramana. If you need supporting, then supporting pramanas are shown as anumana, arthapatti and shabda pramana, shruti as pramana, by saying brahmana ityadi should do this, kshatriya should do this, etc. Therefore, sharira dharmas have already been taken for granted by the shruti to be there in an ashariri akarta atma. Thereby, adhyasa has already been shown by shruti as being accepted by you as soon as you say that I have some kartavya karma. Anumana, we have seen the anvaya vyatireka of adhyasa and vyavahara. And arthapatti, which is anyatha anupapatti, vyavahara won't be possible without adhyasa being there. That also we have seen. Thereby, evam adhyasa uktya. Since adhyasa is, there is a sambhavana, lakshana was given, lakshana, sambhavana and pramana was given. Thereby, brahmatmaike virodha bhavena, there is no virodha. What was the virodha? How can this samsari, karta, bhokta, jiva, bhi, brahma, this alpajnaha, alpashaktiman, ityadi, all these visheshana are there in this jiva, a limited, very limited fellow. How can this be, this jiva be brahma, which is sarvajnya, sarvavit, sarvashaktiman, ishvara, samsara karana. So this has been objected to by saying that there is a huge difference. There is no possibility, not in your dreams, can you have aikya between jiva and atma, jiva and brahma. So adhyasa is there. All the limitations that you have, these are adhyasta in atma. The jivatva bhava is jiva bhava, meaning jivatva. That jivatva is a bhava which is superimposed on oneself and thereby one thinks that one is limited. Thereby adhyasa uktya. Since that is an adhyasa, it is not your swarupa, यू टेक अवे दि अध्यास यू नो दि अध्यास विचारम न सहते वंस यू इंक्वायर इन टू इट इट विल नॉट स्टैंड स्क्रूटिनी देन वॉट इज दि रियालिटी देर इज नो ऑब्जेक्शन पॉसिबल बिकॉज देर आर नो लिमिटेशन ऑल दि लिमिटेशन आर अध्यासकृत वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस अध्यास वंस यू ड्रॉप दैट association which has been erroneous all this while anadikalina then there is no virodha to aikya in fact there is only one there is no pramana for another there is no pramana for dvitiya atma there is no pramana for brahmaatma abrahmaatma api so abrahmaatma api you have no प्रमाण यू कैन नॉट एस्टैब्लिश सो लॉन्ग यू आर सेइंग दैट हाउ कैन यू एस्टैब्लिश ऐक्य बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड आत्मा नाउ आई आस्क यू सेज दिस सिद्धांति इन द एंड यू शो मी सिंस ऑल ऑफ दीज आर अध्यस्त नाउ यू शो मी व्हाट इज द प्रमाण फॉर द्वितीय आत्मा और अनात्मा अब्रह्म फॉर सेगमेंटेड ब्रह्म फॉर सेगमेंटेशन ऑल्सो डू यू हैव एनी प्रमाण देर इज नो प्रमाण एट ऑल Because adhyasa is pratyaksha siddha. What is adhyas? Adhyasta is not your swarupa. Then this swarupa does not have satchit ananda swarupa, does not have a proof of being having another, having a sibling satchit ananda. There is no pramana. In fact, there are some vada granthas where they shift the onus of the siddhanta onto the purvapakshi. So they say, I don't need to answer your Purvapaksha. You have to establish that Purvapaksha question, Prashna itself is valid. How can you validate the question itself? If he says, okay, Upasti naam chitta kraikra dvara, if that is the question, not here, nanu Vedanteshu pranadi upasti naam. So there he says that you establish where is this prana as separate from Brahma. So that is the process. I'm not saying this is the mantra taken, but then there are some granthas where this is the process followed. Aikya is taken for granted. This is the process of the drishti srishti vada. Aikya is the tatparya. Once you understand it, you take it for granted. And then for anything other than aikya, you ask for the pramana. There is no pramana. What is the drishtanta? Swapnavat. If that is pramana, then you have to tell me, is swapna real? Everything in swapna appears to be real. Just because there is bhana like that, does it make it real? No. Thereby, one drishtanta is sufficient. Swapna vat for everything. It's like a master key to open all doors. Any question comes in, you say swapna vato. Is it possible in swapna like this? Whatever you are saying, it is real. No, how can you talk about aikya? All this bheda is right in your face. Yes, it is right. It was right in your face even in your swapna. Did it make it real? No. You woke up to your singular existence. Everything in the dream, the entire dream world, the dream world, the dreamer, your friends, enemies, pranis, pakshis, the sun, the moon, the trees, the entire prapancha of sentient and insentient beings, all those were from you. Who is one without a second? Did it bring about any segmentation in you? No. Was it there even then? And now it has gone on waking up? It isn't so. Similarly, every question is answered by this. If you have proof, then you give proof. There is no proof. Whatever proof he gives, then we can say swapnavat. That is possible in swapna also. Did it make that kind of an objection real there? No. Similarly, here also, this objection does not stand scrutiny. Evam adhyasoktya brahmatmeke virodabhavena vishaya prayojanavatvat. Therefore, there is no virodha in aikya. That is the vishaya. And its prayojana is moksha. Therefore, vishaya prayojana vatvat. The shastra has vishaya and prayojana. Therefore, shastram arambhaniyam iti darshitam iti prathamavarnakam. So, this is the first way to explain a part. The second way to look at it is vicharasya sakshad vishayaha vedantaha. So what is the subject matter of this vichara? Directly you are inquiring into the Upanishad Vakya in this Shastra, in this vichara, which is what is being done in this Mimamsa Shastra. Sharirakam Mimamsa is Vichara Shastra. And Vicharasya Sakshad Vishaya Vedanta Tesham Gatartattva Gatartattvabhyam Arambha Sandehe Krishnasya Vedasya Vidiparatvat Videscha Athato Dharma Jijnyasa Ityadina Purvatantrena Vicharitattvat Avagatarthayo Vedantaha Iti Avyavahita Vishayabhavat Na Arambhaiti Prapte Brute. And the second interpretation after this long discussion, a short second interpretation is what? Whatever, see, adhyasa is not possible. All this was inquired into, was objected. Now what is being said? Since the Vedantas, Gatarthatva, Agatarthatva, Bhyam, Arambha Sandehe. See, something has gone by. Something hasn't come up, but in the discussion, what has gone by? Karma Kanda discussion has gone by, all the Bhashya Sampradaya has gone by, there are sutras, and then Shabara Bhashya on those sutras, Purva Mimamsa sutras, all this is there. Therefore, what is coming up is included there. Why do you say this Vedanta is not covered? Entire Veda is covered. Thereby, Arambha Sandehe Krishnasya Vedasya Vidiparatva, the entire Veda, which is covered in the Purva Mimamsa Sutra Bhashya Sampradaya, and the entire Veda is what? Vidipara. This has been established by Jaimini Sutras. Thereby, Videscha Athato Dharma Jijnyasa Ityana Purva Tantrena Vicharitva. Purva Tantra is Mimamsa, Purva Mimamsa. In the Purva Mimamsa, it has been covered that all the Vedas have Vidhi as Tatparya. And Vidhi, how do you know, how is it inquired into and established? Athato Dharma Jijnyasa, and Adharma Jijnyasa. All that has been seen in the Purva Mimamsa Sutra, Ityadina, Purva Tantrana Vicharitattvat, Vichara has been done, Mimamsa has been done. What more Vichara are you going to do? What Mimamsa are you going to do? It is concluded that all are committed to Vidhi. Avagatartha eva Vedantaha. So whether Gatharthatva, Agatharthatva, the things which have gone by and which are going to come up, they are all Avagatartha. They are all inquired into and known, prior known. Something which is already known, why do you reinvent the wheel? Why do you waste your time and others? So, Avagatartha eva Vedantaha iti avyavahita vishayabhavat na arambha. So there is no other Vishaya left to inquire into. Therefore, Shastra Arambha should not be done. Iti prapte bhute. When this kind of an objection is faced by the Siddhanti, bhute. Siddhanti says what? Vedanta iti. So Vedanta, and this is the second interpretation of Vedanta Vakyanam ityadi, which in the concluding statement, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Vedanta Vishayaka Pujita Vicharatmaka Shastrasya. So, what is Mimamsa? Mimamsa is Pujita Vicharaha. It is Vichara into something which is Pujita. Atma Tattva Brahmatma is, Brahmatma is Pujita Vishaya. That is the Vishaya for the Mimamsa. So, that is the meaning of Mimamsa. Mimamsa means Vichara. Vichara of what? Of Pujita. So, Pujitasya Vichara. Vedanta Vishayaka Pujita Vichara. So, Vedanta Vishayaka is Brahma. Vedanta is the Vishaya, but Vedanta Vishaya itself is Brahma. And therefore, it is a Pujita Vichara. So, Pujita Vichara Atmaka. Pujita Vichara Swarupaka Ichyartha. Shastrasya Vyakhyatumishtasya. Vyachikhyatisa means Vyakhyatumishtasya. That which is desirable to be commented upon. That which is desirable to comment upon. Sutra Sandarvasya Idam Prathama Sutra Vichyartha. So, Sutra Sandarvasya, in this Shastra, which is which begins with athato brahma jinyasa. So there the first sutra is that yadi vidhireva vedartha syat. And then what about my objection? Why should you not do pujita vichara? You can explain that this mimamsa is pujita vichara. Purvapakshi says, where am I saying it is not? Let it be pujita vichara. But what am I saying? It has already been done. Pujita vichara has already been done in Purvamimamsa. Where, what is the conclusion? Vidhi. Vidhi is the tatparya of Krishna Veda. All the Veda. Krishnasya Vedasya Vidhi eva tatparya vishaya. Had it been so, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is not so. Yadi vidhireva vedartha syat. And that is the mind of the Bhagavan Bhashyakara explained by Vyakhyanakara. Tada sarvajnyo bhadarayanaha. This Bhadarayana Vyasa, do you consider as sarvajnya or not? This sarvajnya Vyasa, he would not have written Brahma Sutras. He knows. Just like you say Jaimini, we respect Jaimini Maharshi. Similarly, Vyasacharya also, you cannot object to as having sarvajnyattva. So, Bhadarayanaha Vyasaha Brahmajijnyasam na bruyat. Brahmajijnyasam na bruyat. He wouldn't have talked about Brahmajijnyasa at all. Athato Brahmajijnyasa, that he would not have mentioned at all if it is not that he didn't know Jaimini Sutras existed. He very well knew Jaimini Sutras existed, but they did not cover the Jnana Kanda. The focus of Jaimini Maharshi was only Karma Kanda. He did not get into Vedanta at all. And just like any Purana, Vishnu Purana will do Shiva Ninda, Shiva Purana will Vishnu Ninda, not for Ninda itself. Two, it is a way of Arthavada. Nahi Ninda Nyayena. Nahi Ninda Ninditum Pravartate Apitu Videham Stotum. So to praise what is Videya, other Ninda is done. You should not get lost into Ninda, and you should not have Dvesha towards other deities. You should have Sneha, you should have Bhakti, you should have Sharanabhava unto your own Ishta Devata. That is the purpose of showing that, you know, this Vishnu is great or Shiva is great, by showing the other down. That is not showing the other down, is not the tatparivishya. Similarly, in Karma Kanda, Mimamsa, to encourage people to do Karma Kanda, to follow Karma Kanda, Vedanta Ninda is done, saying that, oh, there is no karma there, therefore all that is Arthavada. That is not the tatparya there. It is not even covered. If you want to look at the Mahima of Shiva, you cannot find that in Vishnu Purana. You have to study Shiva Purana for that. If you want to know the Mahima of Vishnu, you cannot study Shiva Purana and get that. You have to study Vishnu Purana. Similarly here, what is the Tatpare Vishya Vedanta? You have to study Vedanta, not Veda alone. Thereby, yadi vidhireva vedartasya tada sarvajnyo bhadarayanaha brahma jijnyasam na bruyat brahmani manabhavat. Because there is no pramana available, you cannot stumble upon this brahma. The shruti is the only pramana which is hidden in the Upanishad, not in Karma Kanda. And once you inquire into it through this brahma jijnyasa, then only brahma will manifest into your buddhi. There will be brahmakara vritti, and then one will know oneself as brahma, the swarupa of brahma as one's own swarupa. Ataha brahmana jijnyasyatvat jijnyasyatva uktya. Ataha brahmana jijnyasyatoktya. Since brahma jijnyasya jijnyasitum yogya. Since Brahma is fit to be inquired into, since there is no pramana in karma kanda, there is no pramana seen as to what is this brahma. Kenapi tantrena avagata brahma paravedanta vichara arambhaniya iti sutra krut darshayati. So sutra krut kvipratya kartari kvip. So sutra krut, सूत्रकर्ता इत्यर्थ. सो सूत्रकर्ता बादरायण व्यास, भगवान बादरायण व्यास दर्शयति ही शोज एज टू वेदांत विचार आरंभणीय. वेदांत विचार शुड बी डन, वेयर डज ही शो इट, इन द वेरी फर्स्ट सूत्र, अथा तो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा एंड कर्तव्य इति अध्यार्तव्य. भगवान भाष्यकर शोन दैट कर्तव्य पद हैज शुड बी एडेड कर्तव्य बिकॉज जिज्ञासा इज स्त्रीलिंग. तच्च व्याचिख्यासितस्य इति पदेन भाष्यकारो बभाषे, एंड भगवान भाष्यकर सेड दैट वेदांत विचार शुड बी डन. हाउ डज सूत्रकार शो दैट? ही शोज, भगवान भाष्यकर से सूत्रकार शोज दिस बाय सेइंग व्याचिख्यासितस्य. सिंस दैट ब्रह्म शुड बी डिस्क्राइब, देयरफॉर ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा कर्तव्य, एंड सिंस दैट ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा should be elaborated, the vyakhyana should also be done. Thereby, the Tikakara reads that Bhagwan Bhashyakara wants to elaborate the sutra, and Bhagwan Bhashyakara says that the Sutrakara wants to elaborate Brahma, wants to talk about Brahma. Iti Dvitiya Varnakam, this is the second explanation. Thereby, the अध्यास भाष्य व्याख्यान एंड मोस्ट ऑफ टीका इज ओवर. वी डिड मोर देन 50% ऑफ द टीका. पूर्णानंदिया. नाउ जस्ट लेट्स लुक इनटू फोर सूत्रास प्रीटी फास्ट देयर. जिज्ञासा अधिकरण. सो देयर आर अधिकरण इज अ सब्जेक्ट, सब्जेक्ट और टॉपिक, अ सिंगल टॉपिक. देयर इज अ टॉपिक व्हिच इज कनेक्टेड, दे आर ग्रुप टुगेदर इनटू एन अधिकरण. दिस इज ट्रू इन पूर्व मीमांसा सूत्रास ऑल्सो, in Vedanta Sutras also, here it is true. So the first four sutras are four different adhikaranas. There is Jijnyasa Adhikarana. So the Adhikarana subject matter here, Jijnyasa. Atha to Brahma Jijnyasa. We see in this Padachheda is Atha, Ataha, Brahma Jijnyasa. And what does it mean? It means that since after the Atha means after the साधना चतुष्टय संपत्ति बीइंग एक्वायर्ड, मीनिंग अनुबंध चतुष्टय बीइंग देयर, देयर इज एन अधिकारी, देयर इज अ विषय प्रयोजन एंड देयर इज संबंध बिटवीन दीज, देयरफॉर अतः, देयरफॉर ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा, ब्रह्मणः जिज्ञासा, ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा. एंड जिज्ञासा वी हैव सीन बाय लक्षण, वी हैव सीन that it is vichara, vicharaha, brahma jidnyasa kartavya, that is a vritti there. Ataha brahma jidnyasa kartavya, the inquiry into brahma, vichara into upanishad vakyas. So inquiry into brahma through the upanishad vakyas, that is the that which reveals brahma and atma ikya. In conclusion, so that kind of a vichara should be done, that is the meaning. And by whom should it be done? Just like Swarga Kamo Yajeta was given as an example in the opening of the Vyakhyana and Tika, Vyakhyana and Tika, Moksha Kamina. Here Moksha Kamina Kartavya, since Moksha Kami is possible to be there, Adhikari is there, Vishaya Prayojana is there, therefore, Shastramaramaniyam, thereby Athatu Brahma Jidnyasa Karta, Shastramaram meaning Vichara should be done. This is the first sutra. Then the, let's go to a different view there. So let's look at this side itself here. So instead of going into the Bhashya view, let's look at the Sutra view. So you can see all the four sutras. So Jidnyasa Adhikaranam Athato Brahma Jidnyasa. Second Adhikarana for the second sutra is Janmadhyadhikaranam. Janma Adi, Janma Adi Adhikaranam. This is a single word. So Adhikarana, subject matter dealing with Janma Adi, Janma etc. Janmadhyasyataha. So this sutra says Janmadhi Asya Yataha. That is a Padachheda there. Janmadi means Janma Adi Yesham. Te Janmadi. So Janma Adi Yesham. Yesham or Yasya. So Janma Adi. What is Janma Adi? So Janma is at the beginning of which? What is that? Janma, Sthiti and Laya. So Janma, Sthiti and Laya are covered by Janma Adi. Asya, Asya Jagataha, Yataha Bhavati, Yasmat Bhavati. Yata is Panchamyarthe Tasil. There Yataha means Yasmat. Yasmat Bhavati, Janma, Sthiti and Laya. Of this Prapancha is due to which? Yasmat there is not from. We can take it as due to which. It can be from also for Janma. It can be due to, meaning the Adi. Adi Pada includes Laya also. So Laya is not from. There Laya is due to which or into which. So you can interpret Yatha differently there. So Janma Adi Sthiti Bhangaha Yasmat Bhavati. Yasmat Karanat Bhavati. Yasmat Bhavati, yasmat karanat bhavati tat karanam brahma. That karana means jagat sthiti laya karana is brahma. That's what it means. So that is the second sutra. Shastra yonitva adhikaranam. The third adhikarana is shastra yonitva. Yoni is karana again. So shastra yoni of what? Shastra. Not only of the jagat but shastra also. So this has two interpretations. There are two varnakas here. So shastra yonitva adhikaranam, shastra yonitvat. Only one sutra here also. So shastra yonitvat, this is interpreted in two ways. One as shashti tatpurusha shastra. Shastra yonitvat is a single pada, but then as a samasta pada, shastrasya yonihi. So shastrasya yonitvat, brahmana shastrasya yonitvat. Since Brahma is Yoni of the Shastras, meaning is the Karan of Shastras also. Like the Prana, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, somewhere the Tasya Vachaka Pranavaha. And then Shastras also. The Vedas have come from Tasya Vachaka Pranavaha is the name of this thing. But then like the Prana, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, when the Shruti reveals that Shastras, Vedas are like the breath of Ishvara, are the breath of Ishvara. There, Purva Mimamsaka says that you did not create your own breath. So Ishvara will not have created his own breath. Brahma will not have created his own breath. So it is already there. Brahma is breathing out Shastras. If you take it literally, then what does it mean? It means that Shastra has always been there. Prana, it came as Brahma manifests in each and every kalpa, manifests as Ishvara Saguna Brahma, that time the Shastras also manifest. He is not the creator. So Apureshyatvam is that, literally. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, without compromising Apurushyatvam, he says that Shastra came up from Ishvara. So Ishvara is the karta of the Shastras, meaning he manifests the Shastra in the same way that it was there in the earlier kalpa. So jnana of the Shastras is there because Brahma is Sarvajna and there Ishvara is Sarvajna and he manifests. And what is that this Veda. So Veda is like the Shwasa, that is the mantra there. I was trying to recall. So anyway, I am paraphrasing. There, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is not literally the breathing of Ishvara. It is not literally, Vedas are not literally the breath of Ishvara, but it is manifest just like one breathes, meaning effortlessly. That is the meaning. That Nishwasitam is effortlessness of Ishvara to manifest the Vedas the way they were in the earlier Kalpa. So Apurushiyattvam is not compromised, but then Ishvara has manifested in this Kalpa, therefore he is called as a Karta, so to say, Shastra Karta. Although he is not created it, but then it is not that it is literally the breath. But anyway, what does it mean? Vedas have come from Ishvara. So Shastrasya Yonitvat, that is one interpretation by Tatpurusha. The other is by Bahuri. Shastram Yonihi Yasya Brahmanaha Tad Brahma Shastra Yoni and Tasya Brahmana Shastra Yonitvat. So Shastra Yonitvam will be there in Brahma. So Brahmana Shastra Yonitvat, meaning Shastra is the only yoni from which you can get jnana of Brahma. There is no other pramana. Brahma can be known only from Shastras. Therefore, Brahma is Shastra yoni. Brahma has Shastra as its yoni, meaning yoni there is the source. Karana, right? So source means for the Brahma jnana, the source is Shastra. Therefore, Shastra Yonitvat Brahmana, this is the third sutra, both interpretations. This is read in Sampradaya twice. Then Samanvaya Adhikaranam is the fourth Adhikarana. Tattu Samanvayat. So this sutra, Tattu Samanvayat, says that since all the, there is a Samanvaya among all the Upanishad Vakyas, across Shakas, across Mahavakyas and Avantar Vakyas, there is Samanvaya. Since there is a Samanvaya in Aikya, known by Shadlinga analysis of all the Upanishads, one Upanishad also, and you take any Upanishad also, thereby the commitment, Tatpari Vishya, is in Aikya of this Brahma. The Brahma alone is revealed, not anything else. When the Shastra talks about Prana, in Chandogya, for example, the word Prana may have been used. For Hiranyagarbha, which is also Brahma. So there may be other names used. But then Samanvaya, even the Avantar Vakyas have Tatparya in revealing Brahma, and then that Brahma which is Ekameva Advitiya, thereby Aikya. Mahavakyas will show you Aikya directly. Any Vakya which shows Aikya between Brahma and Jiva is a Mahavakya. Although the Sampradaya picks one from one Veda, meaning Upanishad in one Veda, still there are many Mahavakyas in each and every Upanishad. Definitely more than one, because Aikya is Tatpare, whichever Veda mantra, Upanishad mantra, shows Aikya between Jiva and Brahma, that is called as a Mahavakya. So other than those, what are the other Vakyas? They are all Avantara Vakyas. Their Tatpare Vishaya is also Brahma, although not revealing Aikya directly, they reveal Brahma. Therefore, Tattu Samanvayat. Since there is Samanvaya of Brahma, so thereby Samanvaya Adhikaranam, these are the four Adhikaranam. Then Ikshatyadhikaranam Vityadi there. So these first four sutras cover the perspective of the four padas of the entire Brahma Sutra. Here Ikshatyadhikaranam Vityadi, this is going to show, you know, Sankhya and then refutation of Sankhya and other darshanas. So we'll see when we see Brahma Sutra Vritti. Hopefully next we'll see after a break of a month or so. So this ends our study into Brahma Sutra, Adhyasa Bhashya, Vyakhya and the Purnanandiya Tika to a great extent. Anyway, hope this was useful. With a lot of hurdles anyway, by Bhagavan's grace, we have been able to finish this. So let's take a break here with Mangalacharana. So anyway, I'll do both the Mangalacharanas as to यद् ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतम प्रभावात् संसार धीजनित दुःखम अभूजनस्य यद् ब्रह्म धीजनित सौख्यम अभूचतस्य तम रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णमहं नमामि यमय कारुणिकं शरणं गत्वाप्यरी सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहम आशु हरिं परमाश्रय जनक जाम कवनंत सुखाकृतिं तत्सत। सो एनी क्वेश्चंस? Namaste, I'll see you when I see you.
Namaste.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for bearing with all the delays and last minute cancellations of the Patha. I'll see you with whoever is interested in the next Patha, whichever it is. Okay.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Best wishes. Yeah.